iodination, we can do fluorination. But I have taken one example here, chlorination, right? What is the definition here? Substitution of hydrogen by chlorine. You are substituting the hydrogen with what? Chlorine, isn't it? Now let you see, this is the hydrogen of alkane. Hydrogen of alkane, isn't it? Now this is called alkane. Reacting with what here? Chlorine, Cl2, nothing but it is a chlorine molecule, Cl2 molecule, in presence of sunlight, isn't it? In presence of sunlight, you have to remember, in presence of sunlight. Okay, now what happens here? One of the hydrogen replaced with what actually? Chlorine. Now we are going to get, here it is. What we get here? Anybody? What we get on product?
Tell me. Alkyl chloride.
Alkyl chloride means RCl we get, plus byproduct will be HCl, right? Alkyl chloride plus HCl we are going to get. This is the main product for us. So it is, common name is alkyl chloride, IUPAC name is called chloroalkane. With this you can do n number of examples. By placing in the place of R, you put CH3, you put CH3, CH2, like that you can put any alkyl group here, you will get many number of compounds actually, isn't it? To take one, I am taking one example. See, methane I am taking. This is called methane. Okay. Now, this hydrogen we are replacing with the chlorine. So, what happens here? You say, what is the name of the IUPAC name of this?
Chloromethane.
Chloromethane.
Chloromethane. Common name is methyl chloride. Okay. You are going to get chloromethane. Common name is called methyl chloride. This is the reaction. This way you can write n number of reactions actually. Generally we'll take this one will take excess amount, that is not very important for us. Next, reactivity. This is very important for us. Reactivity. When you, because we are having actually fluorine also there. We're having fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Actually, fluorine is what? Highly reactive. So if I take fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, the reaction takes place fastly with fluorine, F, fluorine. Even in dark also the reaction takes place, no need light also. For chlorine, we require light, but fluorine, F, we don't require what? Even light also. In dark also the reaction is taking place. So the reactivity of fluorine is very, very high. For bromine, what happened? We need to heat this, otherwise the reaction does not take place. For iodine, definitely we need a catalyst actually. Without catalyst, the reaction does not take place. That means what is happening here? From fluorine to iodine, the reactivity what happened here? Decreasing. This reactivity what happened here? Decreasing actually. It is also important for us. Okay. Chlorine reacts in dark also, isn't it? Chlorine needs light, bromine needs heat, iodine needs catalyst. Reactivity what happened here? Decreases here. Now, if I take what, two chlorines, for example, isn't it? For example, two more excess. If I told you in the last slide what happened. If I take this one excess, which one? Let me see this one. If I take this one excess here, this part, methane, if I take excess, you are going to get actually this one. Methane, if I take excess amount, you are going to get chloromethane. Okay, you are going to get the chloromethane. If I take chlorine excess, what happens? In this case, what I am taking? Methane, the reactant I am taking excess, the excess amount you are going to get methyl chloride. But if I take excess amount, this one, which one? This one excess amount, which one? Chlorine I am taking excess, this part I am taking excess. Now in this case, what happened? More number of chlorines will substituted here. More number of chlorines will be substituted. So in that case, what we are going to get here? Methylene dichloride, otherwise dichloromethane, isn't it? Dichloromethane, IUPAC name, otherwise methylene chloride is common name. This one you are going to get. When you take what excess amount of chlorine, when you take excess amount of reactant, methane, you are going to get chloromethane, but if you take excess amount of chlorine, you are going to get methylene dichloride, isn't it? Again, if you take one more amount, we are going to get chloroform. This is called what? Chloroform, CsCl3, it is called chloroform. Again, if you take one more chlorine, you are going to get carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. That means whenever if you add a chlorine, one chlorine will be attached to the carbon. So one hydrogen is replaced with chlorine actually. Whenever if you add a chlorine here, what happened? One chlorine will replace one of the hydrogen of the carbon. So that we are going for example, if I take like CH4, okay, I'm taking what, 4 moles of chlorine, 4 moles of chlorine. What we are going to get? CCl4 plus 4 moles of HCl. For example, if I take CH4, isn't it? 3 moles of chlorine. What I'm getting here? Chloroform, CsCl3 plus 3 moles of HCl. In this way, we can write what remaining reactions also. That means if you take excess amount, what happened? We are going to get excess amount of chlorines on carbon. If you take this one excess, what happened? This one, if I take excess, what happened? We are going to get only chloromethane only, isn't it? This is about the halogenation of what? Chlorination of what? Methane. Now, in case of higher alkane, this is important point for us. Very, very important point. In case of higher alkanes, monohalogenation gives a mixture of possible isomeric haloalkanes in which all types of hydrogen atoms are substituted by. To take this example, for example, if I do chlorination for this, what is the name of the compound? Anybody? The name of this compound?
Propane.
Propane. Propane non-reacting with only 1 mole of chlorine. I'm taking how many? Only 1 mole of chlorine. That means one hydrogen will replace with chlorine. If I take only one chlorine, one hydrogen will replace with chlorine. Now tell me which hydrogen will replace. Where it will attack. Whether it attacks here or here or here. It also what same only. Okay. It is one, it is also one chlorine. First position, second position, third position. Our first position, second position, third position. That means what happened? Both are same only. First and third are both are same. Okay? Right. Now this one is, which type of carbon it is? Can you say this carbon? Which type of carbon? Primary, secondary, tertiary? This carbon answer. What?
Primary.
Very good. Third carbon is a primary carbon. Even first carbon also what happened? First carbon what? Primary. What about secondary? What about second?
Secondary.
Very simple. A carbon bonded to two carbons is called secondary. A carbon bonded to one carbon or no carbon is called primary. Here also a carbon bonded to one carbon primary. Now remember, when you take monochlorination means nothing but what? Only you are adding one chlorine. I'm adding a monochlorination. Mono means you are adding only one chlorine. One chlorine. Isn't it? That means you are taking propane is excess amount, chlorine is less amount. Now, in that case, what they are saying, tertiary hydrogen is more reactive when you compare with secondary hydrogen, and secondary is more reactive when you compare with primary hydrogen. This is the statement they are giving actually. So, tertiary hydrogen is readily reactive when you compare with secondary hydrogen and primary. Now, tell me what is the answer for this one? The product name is what?
2-chloropropane.
Very good. 2-chloropropane. So when you do what happened, you will get two types of products. What is that one? First one. This one is 1-chloropropane, but it is minor. Very minor it is. Okay. 1-chloropropane. Next one you are going to get here, isn't it? This one, major product. This is called what? 2-chloropropane. You are getting how much here? 55%. This is the major product. In examination, if they ask, you have to give this one as the answer. Examination, generally nobody asks minor product. Generally they will ask major product. So the answer must be 2-chloropropane. Major product we have to identify, isn't it? That if you remember, this one is very simple. First of all, you need to know how to identify primary, secondary and tertiary hydrogen. Once if you know the primary, secondary, tertiary hydrogen, the remaining is very simple for you. Now this is about very important topic. You make a notes on this one. Okay, this is very, very important point. So you have to write on your notebook this reaction. So chlorination taking place on primary and secondary, but major is what? 2-chloro. Secondary is what? Major product it is. Now let me move to what? Next slide. Chromination, same thing, but we need to heat this one. We need to heat this one. That is the thing is that we need to heat this one. Now, all these reactions are periodical substitution reactions. I will explain later once we complete what type of reaction it is. I will explain later. First we complete. iodination is reversible. Why? Because it need catalyst. The reaction generally does not take place. We need, why? Because one thing I will explain. If an examination, isn't it? Especially high order thinking questions, you will get a question like this. Why this reaction is reversible reaction? That means forward reaction is not taking place. Yield you are getting what? Less. The reason is what? Hydrogen iodate. This is the reason actually. Hydrogen iodate. Why? Because it's highly unstable. It's highly unstable it is. Highly unstable it is. Because of highly unstable, isn't it? It will undergo backward reaction again. Convert into iodine again. So in examination, if they ask why iodination is reversible in nature, why the iodination generally does not take place here? Because the formed byproduct, which you are calling hydrogen iodide, the formed byproduct, which you are calling as hydrogen iodide, is highly unstable. That will again decompose into what? Iodine. That is the reason it leads to backward reaction. That is the reason it is a reversible reaction. So this is also important for you. Why it is a reversible reaction, isn't it? That is very important for you, isn't it? You have to remember this. You make notes, because when I send this one, what happened, this will what will be erased, because I am not saving this one. If I save what happened, this whatever this PDF, no, that will be not visible for you. This is okay, but previous what happened, I have written everything. So in that case, what happened, you can't visible the main slides actually. Isn't it? So you have to make this one on the notebook. What you have to write in the notebook? Iodination is reversible reaction because the formed byproduct hydrogen iodide is highly unstable, leads to backward reaction. This point you have to remember. Next, if you observe what happened, now this is the statement. Now how to prevent this one? I told you that you have to take some catalyst, something. What? How to prevent this one? You need to take some oxidizing agents like mercuric oxide, HiO3, HNO. Generally, we'll take HNO3. In examination, generally, they will give HNO3. HNO3, HiO3, mercuric oxide. What happens? No, these HNO3 will inhibit what? Whatever the formed Hi actually. So, how to prevent this one? So, if you inhibit this one, if you remove this one, backward reaction does not take place. How to inhibit this one? By taking some oxidizing agents. These oxidizing agents will inhibit what actually, will remove what actually, Hi. So that what happened? Forward reaction proceeds. Next, we'll see some questions now. Let me see some of the questions here. What you learn, let me see now. Whatever you learn, now let me see. The oxidizing agent added to prevent the reversibility of iodination of alkane. What will be the answer here?
All of these.
All the mercuric oxide. Generally, in the textbook, what happened? They are giving HNO3, HiO3. You can take even mercuric oxide also. Chlorination of methane gives. What should be the answer? Chlorination of methane will give. What will be the answer here?
Chloromethane.
Now,
all of the above.
Now, listen. They didn't given anything. Excess not given. You may get anything, no? Chlorination of methane may give what? Methyl chloride, CH2Cl2, CCl4, all are possible here. So if they given all of these, you have to give all of, because all are possible, because they didn't mention which is excess. Methane or excess, if it, methane is excess, what happened? Methyl chloride, chlorination excess, what happened? All. So that is the reason what happened. All of these are possible actually. So now we'll move to what next slide now. Next slide, let me take. With alkenes, we'll see now. Only 31 students are present today. 36. Who is absent today? Anybody know that one? Including me, it is 36, means, sir. 4 students were absent today. Total 4. 37 means 36. 3 students were absent. Previous Priyanshu absent, present? Ah, yes, Priyanshu is there. Deva is there, yes. Amruta, Anupama. Okay, no problem. Let me see this one. Now we see the Markovnik cuff rule now, yeah? Markovnik cuff rule for what? All kings, okay? Now before that, one thing I have to clear here. Before this Markovnik cuff rule, one thing I have to clear. So whatever we discussed, halogenation of alkane, that reaction is free radical substitution reaction. That reaction is called free radical substitution reaction. Substitution reaction. Isn't it? So whatever we learn now, halogenation of alkane. Alkane, halogenation of alkane is what type of reaction it is? Halogenation of alkanes. Alkanes is nothing but actually free radical substitution reaction. That means what actually what happens? Let me see one example. I will take one example here. CH3 hydrogen. Okay. First of all, we'll do one thing. First of all, chlorine. You take chlorine here. This chlorine undergo homolytic cleavage. Anybody knows what is homolytic cleavage? What is the meaning of homolytic cleavage?
Electrons are equally distributed when the bond is breaks.
The electrons are equally distributed like this. So what we are going to get? 2 moles of with chlorine free radical. This is called free radical. Free radical it is. Cl is a free, this one is a free radical. Okay. Now this is forming. Next after that what happened? CH3. I am writing CH4 like this. Okay. This is a CH4 methane. Now this is also undergoing what actually? Free radical, homolytical cleavage. It is also undergoing homolytical cleavage like this. One carbon, one. This dot is nothing but electron. I'm putting what dot means is a electron. Now one electron for hydrogen, one electron for the carbon. So you got methyl free radical. Methyl free radical it is. Free radical. Now this one is hydrogen free radical. This part is what? Hydrogen free radical. Now what happens here? You got 2 chlorines now here. Now what I'm doing here, in short, I'm writing CH3, one free radical plus one chlorine is there now here. I've taken out of two chlorines, I will take one chlorine here. Okay. So you are going to get what actually CH3, isn't it? Cl, chloromethane you are going to get. So which type of reaction now? Free radical substitution reaction it is. Now this one hydrogen free radical is there already. This hydrogen free radical and one chlorine, all 2 chlorines already there, no? So out of one I have already used here. Second one I am taking here, second chlorine also I am using here to give a HCl. Now this type of reactions are called what? Free radical substitution reaction. Why? Because hydrogen substituted with chlorine. In what type of reaction they substituted here? Free radical mechanism. The mechanism is free radical mechanism. But in the case of actually what happens, you may get like this also. If I take 2 moles here, for example, if I take 2 moles here, that means you will get 2 moles of this one also will get 2 moles here. If I take 2 moles, we get 2 moles of methyl free radical we may get here. They may undergo combination here. So in that case, you are going to get ethane also possibility. That means it is also possibility, but very less amount, minor product. Very minor product. Similarly, 2 hydrogens also may combine, isn't it? To give what? Hydrogen also. Okay. So this is about actually mechanism of free radical substitution reactions, halogenation of alkane, right? It will be there in the textbook. You will get everything in the textbook, this mechanism. Just you have to observe. Once you observe what happened, when you read textbook, it will be easy for you. Now let me move to what? Halogenation of alkanes. Halogenation of alkenes. I'm just roughing this one. Right. I have taken this alkene. Now, what is we are discussing? Halogenation of alkenes. No, second topic. Halogenation of alkenes we are discussing now. Halogenation of alkenes. Second, alkenes is over. Now we'll see alkenes. Now one example I have taken for alkene is called ethylene. This is the ethylene. Ethene or ethylene we can call this. Ethylene or ethene also we can call. Ethene is a IUPAC name. This is the IUPAC name, ethene. And ethylene is a common name actually. Now this is treating with what actually? Already there. This is the IUPAC. Now this is treating with what actually? Chlorine now. Okay. Generally chlorine will take because high reactivity, you know. But remember one thing I have forgotten here. Which is more reactive means fluorine, no, highest reactivity. Because of its high reactivity, generally we don't do fluorination directly. Okay. Nobody do fluorination directly because it's highly reactive, no. So in dark also the reaction takes place, no. So that is the reason it may explode. It may lead to what? Exothermic reaction. So explosivity. So directly no one treat fluorine with what? Hydrocarbons. Definitely what happened? It will lead to, isn't it? Explosion. So the person who identified the fluorine, no, he lost his eye actually because of this explosive what happened. The scientist lost his eye also. That is the reason. So nobody do fluorination. F fluorination we don't do directly, isn't it? So that is the reason I'm taking ex. Whenever I take example, what I will take chlorine or bromine will take. Iodine also we don't take. Why? Because iodine is which type of reaction? Reversible reaction. So in any case, most of the case, what will take? Reagent like chlorine or bromine. Generally we'll take chlorine or bromine actually. Now this is the solvent. CCl4 is a solvent, isn't it? It is not reagent. Reagent is chlorine. Ethylene is a reactant. CCl4 is a solvent. Now what happens here? Very simple. You have to cleave the pi bond. You have to cleave the pi bond, only pi bond, not sigma bond. You have to cleave only what? Pi bond only, isn't it? This pi bond we need to cleave here. Then give one chlorine to CH2, give another chlorine to CH2. Now what we are going to get in this? Very simple. Cleave the pi bond, not sigma bond. Cleave the pi bond, give the two chlorines to two double bond carbons. Here remember, to which carbon we are going to give chlorines here? Double bond carbons we need to give. Now plus, you are going to get some byproduct also. The byproduct will be what? No byproduct. In this case, it is addition reactions. This reaction is called what? Addition reaction. Now in addition reaction, remember, you don't get any byproduct. In addition reactions, what happened? There is no byproduct. Why you don't get byproduct? Because everything you are adding, no. When you get adding, how you get the byproduct here? When you add, what happened? We get single product. So whenever you add, what happened? Isn't it? You will get single product. So no, there is no byproduct. Now one important thing is that here, this reaction usefully for unsaturation test. Test for what? Unsaturation. Okay. This is useful for unsaturation test. Unsaturation means what? Having pi bonds. If anything is having pi bond, that is called what? Unsaturation. Saturation means what? No pi bond. Any hydrocarbon, if it is having pi bond, they are called unsaturated. Alkenes, alkynes, both are having pi bonds. Therefore, they are called unsaturated compounds. Where alkene called saturated because they don't have any pi bond. Okay. So, how to identify unsaturated compounds? By using the chlorine and CCl4. But this reaction cannot be identifiable. We can do, but this cannot be, because both are color. This one is colorless. See, this one is colorless. And this one also colorless. It is also colorless. Now, how do you identify now here? You can write on a paper, but when you do perform the reaction, nothing is changing there. When you add a reagent to the reactant, nothing is changing here. Now, how do you know the reaction is completed? How do you know the reaction is taking place? So that is the reason what happened. This process can be taken, but chlorine cannot be taken here. Okay. So what I mean to say is that unsaturation means having pi bond. Okay. Having pi bond. Now, how to identify, how to observe this one? So in that case, you take in place of chlorine, you take bromine CCl4 because bromine is having some color. Okay, I will explain in the next slide that. Now, what I mean to say in this case, what happened? Cleave the pi bond, put the two chlorines on double bond carbon. Now, what is the name of this one? Ethylene dichloride. Ethylene dichloride is which type of halide it is? Zeminal or vicinal?
Vicinal.
Vicinal. Vicinal means what happened? On adjacent to carbon. Okay. So, IUPAC name is called what? One number, two number. So, 1, 2 dichloroethane. Isn't it? I will take what? Just a minute. Now I will do one thing. In this only I will explain. Now I am doing what actually here? Bromine I will take. I take what? Bromine. What happens? Writing here. Same thing. CH2 double bond. CH2 reacting with bromine Br2 against CCl4. The solvent is same only. Now you are going to get CH2 it is what? Bromine. And here also what happened? You are going to get the bromine. What is the name of this product? What's the name of ethylene dibromide or 1, 2 dibromoethane. Now what I'm saying here, bromine CaCl4 is having reddish brown color. The color of this one is called reddish brown color. It is reddish brown color. It is reddish brown color. Okay, which one reagent is having reddish brown color? Now when you add this reddish brown colored bromine CaCl4 to ethylene, that this become colorless. It becomes colorless. Now easily we can identify the reaction is took place. The reactant is what now? Unsaturated compound. You can't say it is alkene. It may be alkyne also. Okay. You can't say it is alkene. It may be alkane also, because I am saying it is unsaturated only. Unsaturated will comes under in alkene and alkynes. Both are unsaturated. So what I mean to say is that by using bromine CCl4, we can test unsaturation compounds. That means we can test what happened, alkenes and alkynes, isn't it? For example, I given X, Y, and Z I given. Three samples are given. Now these are treating with what? These three are treating with what? Bromine and CCl4. Differently, not collectively, differently. Now X is giving, okay, colorless. X is giving colorless compound. Okay. Y is giving colored compound. Colored compound. And Z is giving colorless compound. Now, based upon these, can you say which is alkane? Which is alkane? Which is alkane? The question understood. I have taken X,
Z.
Okay. X and Z. X is giving colorless compound. Y is giving colored compound. Z is giving colorless with bromine CCl4. So when you treat with bromine CCl4 colored compound, reddish brown colored compound, unsaturated are converting into colorless. Okay. Now X is colorless, right? Z is colorless. When you add bromine CCl4, that means X and Z both are actually what? Unsaturated compounds. Both are unsaturated compounds. This one also unsaturated. This one also what? Unsaturated. That means they may alkene or they may alkyne. But why if you observe what happened, this Y part, if you observe what happened, this Y part is still colored. That means the color of reddish brown color is not decolorized. The color of the bromine CCl4 is not decolorized by alkanes. So very simple note you write here. Bromine CCl4 do not decolorized by alkanes, but they are decolorized by decolorized by whom? Alkenes and alkynes. So the point you need to remember here, very simple point. Bromine CCl4 is useful for test for unsaturation, in which both alkenes and alkynes will decolorize the bromine CCl4. That means decolorization of reddish brown color of bromine CCl4 can be done by what? Both alkenes and alkynes, which are unsaturated carbons. Next, alkanes, they do not decolorize the bromine CCl4 of reddish brown color, isn't it? They are what? Saturated hydrocarbons. This is the important thing you need to remember. Test for unsaturation. Even in the practical also, you will get this test. Now, shall I move to what next slide now? You have to note down this one. Note down this part. I'm moving to what? Next slide. Next thing, again with alkenes. Now I'm using what? Not halogens. I'm taking hydrohalogen. HX I have taken now. I'm taking here what? HX I'm taking here. HX. Okay. Now, for example, if I add, isn't it? Now, one more thing I've forgotten here. This slide. More thing. If I write like this, CH3, CH double bond CH2, I'm adding what here? Chlorine in presence of CCl4. Can you say what is the product name now? Tell me the product name here. The product name, tell me the product name. I'm not there. Voice is audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This light is on. I thought my voice is cut. Okay. You are not replying, so that I thought it is the Google Meet. It was. Now, next. So I think you are discussing this one. You have to, when I ask question, no. If you replay that, then only I will know that you are connecting online. Otherwise, what happened? I think the connection will cut. No. So can you give answer for this one? What is the answer for this one? Just now we discussed this one only, no? Are you there or not?
One comma two dichloropropane.
Very good. Now I told you many number of times you have to break the pi bond. You have to break the pi bond and put the chlorines on only double bond carbon. You can't put the chlorine on here because it is a single bond carbon, sigma bonded carbon. You can't place any chlorine on this carbon. Where we need to place the chlorines? On double bond carbon, wherever double bond is there, here double bond is there. Now put this, isn't it? Here is, isn't it? Now what we get here? CH3, CH, CH2. Here we need to put one chlorine. Here we need to put two chlorine. Understood here? So all of you write down this one. Write down this one in your notebook. This is called what? Propene. When you treat propene with the chlorine presence of CCl4, we are going to get 1,2 dichloropropane. Also called vicinal halide, no? IUPAC name it is. Isn't it propylene dichloride? Common name is propylene dichloride. You have to note down this one on the notebook. All of you note down this one on the notebook. So remember, only double bond carbons will get the halogens, not single bond carbon. If you remember this one, they, you can make easily answer now. Now let me take now next slide now here. Addition of halo acids, HX, like hydrochloric acid, hydrofluoric acid, hydrobromic acid. Now in this case, what happened? Hex means you can take chlorine, bromine, and iodine. You can take it. Now we'll take one example here. This one, CH2 double bond CH2 on treating with what? HCl. Okay. Now you are going to get what? Addition reaction in this way. So what happens here? Will hydrogen will move here and chlorine will move here. So we are going to get what? Chloroethane we are going to get here. Trifluoride, you are going. This is very simple reaction. No? In the previous case, what you have done? You have done chlorine, addition of chlorine. Two chlorines you have added to the double bond carbon. Now we are adding what? One hydrogen, one chlorine. If you take HBr, we are going to get bromoethane. If I take HI, we are going to get iodoethane, right? Very simple, no? Now, what about unsymmetrical? Now, if I add HCl to this one, okay? Now, what should be the product? What should be the product? We get a doubt actually, whether whether the hydrogen will add here or chlorine will add here. Which one is the correct one? Yes, sorry. Hydrogen will add here. Which one is the correct one? In this case, whether hydrogen will add CH double bond carbon or CH2 double bond carbon? This is the question. Do fast, already 10 minutes only there. Which class?
Sir, that is not visible to me, sir.
It is not visible to you.
CH2 double bond. Down.
If you, remaining, it is visible for you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Whoever not visible, you just click on that one. That whichever I screen share that, no, that you click again, you will get that one. Now we have to follow which rule? Markovnikov rule. Okay. You got in the 11th class, you got this concept. Markovnikov rule. What is Markovnikov rule? According to this rule, the negative part, isn't it? The negative part always attacks the double bond carbon, which is having less number of hydrogens. The negative part is what? This part is the negative part. This part is the negative part. Okay. Attacks the double bond carbon. I'm not saying single bond carbon. This I'm not saying. I'm saying about double bond. These two I'm saying. Attacks the double bond carbon having less number of hydrogens. Here. This will be the major product. Now, based upon this, what happened? What is the product we are going to get? Markovnikov rule? The negative part. This is the negative part. Attacks the double bond carbon having less number of hydrogens. Less number of hydrogen atoms. So that we are going to get the answer like this here. So here it is. You observe here what happened. Now, negative part. This is the negative part. Attacking the double bond carbon having less number of hydrogens. Less number of hydrogens. So you are going to get what product here? Like this. 2-chloropropane is the major product. This one is the major product. What will be the minor product here? Opposite. If chlorine attacks here, what happens? Isn't it? That will be the minor. If chlorine attacks here at the double bond CH2, that will be the minor product. 2-chloropropane or isosecondary propyl chloride also, we can call this one. So this one is the major product. What will be the minor product here? Opposite. CH3CH2CH2Cl. Okay, this is the minor product we are doing. Point to the Markovnikov rule. If it is unsymmetrical alkene, in that case, the negative part, the halogen, attacks the double bond carbon having less number of hydrogen atom. This point also very important for us. Now let me take HBr, propene, HBr I take. Okay, now tell me what is the peroxide. Now I am taking here what? Peroxide here. Now I am taking here peroxide. In the previous case, I didn't take anything. Only HCl I have taken, nothing I have taken. Now here I have taken additionally what? Peroxide. Now here, which tool we have to follow here? According to 11th class, anti-Markovnikov rule we have to follow. According to anti-Markovnikov rule, the negative part will attack the, isn't it? Double bond carbon having more number of hydrogens. Opposite to Markovnikov rule. Okay? So this is also called what? Anti-Markovnikov rule, rash effect you can call, or peroxide effect you can call, or abnormal peroxide effect you can. Generally what happens? Use this one. Peroxide effect. The remaining no need to use that words. The main words are, one is peroxide effect or one is rash effect it is. According to peroxide effect, we are going to get what type of product here? Anti-Markovnikov product we are going to get. Anti-Markovnikov product here. Negative part will attach on double bond carbon having more number of hydrogen atoms. To avoid the confusion, you remember only Markovnikov rule. So whenever you want to use anti-Markovnikov rule, you should do opposite way. Opposite is nothing but what? More number of hydrogen. Remember less only, but anti-Markovnik do opposite. Otherwise you will get confusion, which is Markovnik, which is anti-Markovnik, less or high, that will get some doubt actually. So according to this, what should be the product now here? 1-bromopropane. You are going to get here 1-bromopropane. Or N-propyl bromide. This is the anti-Markovnik rules actually, isn't it? Now, I will take one example here. CH3CH double bond CH2. Right? I am treating with what? HCl. Okay? Again, HCl in presence of peroxide. Next, what happened? HBr in presence of peroxide. Now, here what should be, I am writing only major products only. Now tell me what is the product, major product in this case, first case? Do first.
Markovnikov
product. The name of that one will be?
2-chloropropane.
2-chloropropane is the major product. What about this one? When you take peroxide. Same product we get here. Same product. No change. That means peroxide effect does not on HCl. Because the bond strength is more on HCl. That is the reason what happened. Peroxide effect is no effect. There is no effect. You will get what? Same product only. This you learn already in the 11th class. Now HBr. Only HBr if I take what happened. You are going to get CH3. Isn't it? CH3Br. Again, you are going to get what happened. This is the major product. The major product here it is Markovnikov. Markovnikov rule. It also what happened? Markovnikov. But peroxide effect will be there here because it is having what? Less bond strength. The HBr is having very less bond strength. That is the reason definitely you are going to get here anti-Markovnikov product here. So this will be the major product I am writing. The product is based upon anti-Markovnikov rule. So what I mean to say is that according to 11th class, you will learn this point. But anyhow, here also we'll discuss again thing. HCl do not have peroxide effect, whereas HBr is having peroxide effect. Okay. What is peroxide effect? It is based on anti-Markovnikov rule in which the negative part will attach the double bond carbon having more number of hydrogens. Whereas Markovnikov rule is the negative part attacks on double bond carbon having less number of hydrogens. Understood here?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll see the how to prepare the ziminal dihalides here. How to get the ziminal dihalides now. Because geminal halides means we need to get two halides, no? By using what? Acetal. If you want to get the geminal halides, isn't it? From the alkenes, is it possible? Geminal halides? Tell me, beta. Is it possible geminal halides? Let me see again. CH2 double bond CH2. CH3 CH double bond CH2. Is it possible to form geminal halides by using this one?
No.
We get what type of halides, tell me?
Vicinal.
Vicinal. Now my question is now here, how to prepare geminal halides? Geminal halides means we have to place the two halogens on same carbon. So how to place, because in conversions they are asking this type of questions, isn't it? If they ask this type of question, what happened? You need to proceed in this way actually. So take alkyne. Take alkane, which is nothing but acetylene you take here. Take an acetylene here. Okay, nothing but ethane. It is ethane. Okay, IUPAC is ethane. Now do chlorination here. That means what happened? Doing HCl. Now what happened here? There is no Markovnik couple because the symmetrical molecule. You are going to get what type of molecule compound here? Isn't it? You observe here what happened? Addition. One will get hydrogen, other will get the chlorine. You are going to get here this product. CH2 double bond Cl. This is getting the hydrogen. This part getting what? Chlorine. Okay. So definitely this becomes now what? The pi bond we need to remove here. One pi bond only, not all pi bonds, only one pi bond. One addition, one pi bond. Two addition, two pi bonds we have to remove. Now after this again add HCl now. This is called vinyl chloride, already you know this one. Now again add one more HCl now. One more HCl now. Add one more HCl now. Now we have to follow what here? Markovnikov rule. Now follow what here? Markovnikov rule. According to the Markovnikov rule, the negative part attacks the double bond carbon having less number of hydrogen. Now this is having what? Less number of hydrogens here. Now the chlorine attacks where? Here. And the hydrogen will attacks where? Here. So what we are going to get here? Markovnikov rule here. Like this. This is now called geminal dihalide. Ethylidine dichloride. Geminal dihalides were good. Now how to get the geminal halides? Isn't it? In this way we can do. So what I have done here? I have taken acetylene, CH, triple bond CH. I have treated first with what actually? HCl. Okay? You got something what actually? Vinyl chloride you got. I am not writing the product here, only I am writing the name. Vinyl chloride. You are going to get. Now this vinyl chloride again treated with HCl, you got geminal halides. In this way you need to remember. Okay? This is already, you know this one, leave it this one. Markovnikov rule is applied to which type of
unsymmetric.
Unsymmetrical.
Whenever if you get unsymmetrical alkene only, we need to follow Markovnikov rule. Otherwise, if you follow, no problem, you don't get. Because no need. Even to follow what happened, you don't get any problem. If HBr is added to unsymmetrical alkene, friends of peroxide, which type of effect it is called?
Both
B and C we can call this one. Ethylene is treated with chlorine presence of ethylene, it is. Chlorine presence of carbon tetrachloride. What is the product you are going to get here? Ethylene means CH2 double bond CH2, treating with chlorine. In presence of CCl4. Tell me what is the name of the product here?
Both B or C.
B or C.
So we are going to get vicinal. We are going to get vicinal. This one is actually geminal. So geminal we don't get directly like this. So answer will be what? D only. Some more present preparations, let me see. By halogen exchange reaction. Now after this, whatever we discussed now with the alkenes and alkanes. Now let me take the next method, halogen exchange. Now what is the use of halogen exchange means? Because until now we are using what? Chlorine and bromine only. Most of the cases we are using what? Chlorine and bromine only. Chlorine we are not using because of high reactivity. What happened? Chlorine is a super halogen, so high reactivity we are not using directly. Even iron also we are not using. Why? Because in most of the cases HI is forming, where HI is actually what? Highly unstable. HI is a highly unstable, will undergo decompose to give what? Backward reaction. That is the reason we are not making the forward reactions here. So to get the fluoroalkanes, to get the iodoalkanes, isn't it? what we have to do? We have to exchange the halogens. So there are two halogens exchange methods are there. One is called what? Then it's Schwarz reaction. Other is called what? Finkelstein reaction. Two reactions are there. Finkelstein and Schwarz reaction. Two reactions generally useful for what? Exchange of halogen. This very, very important reactions, isn't it? Named reactions, important one for conversions. Generally, you will get this type of reactions. So what I'm saying now here in this slide, listen carefully. We cannot prepare fluoroalkanes and iodoalkanes. Why? Because fluorine is highly reactive and iodine wants the product formed as HI, byproduct formed as HI, which is highly unstable. So to prepare fluoroalkane and iodoalkane, we are using some halogen exchange reactions. One is called Finkelstein reaction, other is called what? Schwarz reaction. Let me see first one, what is this Finkelstein reaction? It's Finkelstein reaction to prepare iodoalkanes. I want to prepare what type of reactions? Iodoalkanes or alkyl iodides. Now I can take X. Here X equal to what we can write here? Chlorine or bromine. X equal to chlorine or bromine. We can take. Now the what is the reagent in this Finkelstein reaction? Sodium iodide is the reagent. The solvent we use, generally acetone we use here, isn't it? Acetone we use as a solvent here. Okay, sodium iodide and acetone we are using here. Now what happens here? Both will be removed. Both means what? NaX is will be removed and iodine will be attacked. Okay. Now what we are going to get? Ri. You got now. You see X replaced with what here? Iodine. X is exchanged with what? Iodine. So this is the reaction actually. We'll take one example here. We'll take one example here. Let me see the example here. I am taking the example here. CH3CH2 chlorine, I am taking, reacting with sodium iodide in presence of dry acetone, whatever thing, acetone I am writing, simply I am writing acetone. Okay, now these two is removed, NaCl is removed and you are going to get CH3CH2, isn't it? For example, if I take what happens, CH3Br, treat with sodium iodide. Now again, on heating and acetone, you are going to get CH3iodine plus NaB. This is the thing you are going to get. Very simple or not? Finkelstein reaction, exchange of chlorine or bromine with iodine. Isn't it? This is called what? Finkelstein reaction. So note down these reactions, all of you. Which class you are having now? 11 o'clock?
Sir, we have bio, so we have to join early.
Okay. At what time you have to join now? Now? Okay. Within 2 minutes, I will conclude now. That one more reaction is there. With that, I will conclude now. Only 1-2 minutes it will complete. Schwarz reaction. Now, in this case, we prepare fluoroalkanes. So, Finkelstein reaction for iodoalkane, Schwarz reaction for fluoroalkanes, right? Now, again, you take what? AGF. You can take here AGF. Again, AGBr will be removed. We are going to get RF. Fluoroalkanes we are going to get, isn't it? This way, you will get the product actually, isn't it? Next, you can take many number of things are there. You can take not only AGF, you can take HG2F is there, isn't it? Again, SBF also is there something. There are number of reagents are there, not only AGF. Mainly, we will take silver chloride actually, okay? This is about the Schwarz reaction. Now, one question will arise here. Okay, this we'll discuss in the next class, whatever the topics are there, it takes time. Okay, in the next class, we'll see this one. Only 34, remaining what? What about remaining one? They log out early. Okay, no problem. Now, all of you submitted your CTC exam?
No, sir.
Not get-
if anybody not submitted, submit today only, because today is the last date. Everyone.
Sir, we are busy.
Everyone must attempt this exam. Otherwise, they will put absent, isn't it? So compulsory, submit today only. CCT 6 you need to complete today. CCT 7 you need to complete by 7th. That means day after tomorrow, you have to complete. Okay. If you have anybody doubts you're having, you can stay with me. Otherwise, you can leave out. All of you make notes and complete the exercise, whatever given yesterday I given exercise, nominal, complete that one. If you have any doubts, you can stay, otherwise you can log out.
Sir,
Bolo.
Sir, is minor product possible if we do a reaction practically?
Minor product means possible only we are writing minor. No, minor means it is possible when you are actually. It is possible only. No. Example.
Sir, but what's the chances of getting a minor product?
I given no. One is what 52%. I given something. Some it depends upon the which type of reactant you take. The calculation part will be there. Some will get 75%, remaining 25% will be minor. Both will get, okay, because both chance, because it depends upon probability. So based upon the probability, we have to say which is more probable. We can say as a major product. Major means you may get 75% or 80%, something like that. Minor will get 25%. After formation of the,
okay, sir.
To do, you have to separate that. When you separate, you will get which percent, how much percentage you got actually.
Sir, sir, but in the today's example, what we discussed, sir.